had been known as the hippies' disappointment. And for those new people, certainly I'm glad to give you a little history of this. Of course, in the mid-1960s, cannabis and marijuana were becoming very popular here in the U.S. The Beatles, the Vietnam War, etc. Everyone wanted a little de-stress, relaxation, so marijuana became very popular. And with this, some of the more progressive marijuana growers thought, oh gosh, there's another cannabinoid, CBD. Let's see if we grow a high concentration CBD in a marijuana crop, maybe we can get a little bit better effect or something different. So they went ahead and did this, and when they smoked their cannabis cigarette with the CBD in it, there was no effect. So CBD became known as the hippie's disappointment. And this lasted for almost 50 years until Mike and his group, and I was fortunate to be part of this as an investor, came along. And our theory was that, okay, when you smoke a cannabis cigarette, you only get 1 or 2 milligrams, not enough to maybe be, you know, therapeutic or have any potential health and wellness benefits. But suppose we did this different. Suppose we went ahead and extracted the oils and made tinctures or other ingestible products. And all of a sudden, if you can get 25, 50, maybe 100 milligrams of CBD on a daily basis, perhaps there'd be some therapeutic benefits. Something might help people's overall health and wellness. And so we thought about this, and certainly Mike and his group, since 2007, had been working with European farmers to grow a high concentration CBD into a hemp crop. And by the fall of 2011, just, you know, 9 months or so after he purchased the company, Medical Marijuana Inc., from its original founders, that we actually had a high enough concentration CBD in this European hemp crop to potentially be therapeutic. So what we did was went ahead, did our harvest and extractions over in Europe, and took this CBD-rich hemp oil. It was really kind of more like a thick paste, if you will. But we were able to then develop import-export regulations to take it from Europe into the United States. We had our first proof-of-concept products available right around the end of the year 2011. And then we actually had our first hemp-based nutraceutical CBD products on U.S. and world markets in the spring of 2012. And that was the founding of one of our portfolio companies, HempMist, at that time. And we never knew that we were even going to sell $1 worth of product, that it was going to be anything that people were going to utilize. Obviously, hemp food products have been very popular in the U.S., and so we assumed that there might be some interesting things to happen. And rather than go do 5 and 10 years worth of research so we might be able to actually make a claim about some of the potential benefits, we just thought, well, we'll just market this product with no claims, zero claims, to the general public. Let them use it for their overall health and wellness and see what comes back from the public's feedback. And of course, over time, we've seen some tremendous benefit, just anecdotally, many stories here of the Canaway family. And certainly, it's been a great ride and evolution ever since. Of course, we see many parents with their anecdotal stories about utilizing this with their children with epileptic seizure disorders. We've had some clinical study and research in Mexico, which I'll present a little bit later in my presentation. But certainly, it's been game-changing for the world. Since we came to the public markets, there are about another 230 companies who've also followed our lead, come to the public space. And of course, today online, you can find all kind of CBD products and many manufacturers and people selling CBD. But we're trying to really become the professional company and kind of an emerging and very unprofessional space, as Blake likes to say. So our parent company, Medical Marijuana Incorporated, we have 4 divisions in nutraceutical sales. Of course, our new up-and-coming flagship company here, Canaway, is doing some great things. We now have, I think, about 18,000 brand ambassadors here in the U.S., 3,000 or 4,000 overseas in Europe, and certainly we're very excited about the international expansion opportunities. In our neighbor to the north, Canada, hopefully ICA and group will be able to get our products into Canada very soon, and certainly we're excited about Mexico, Brazil, where HempMex now is selling products. And for some of these countries, it's only available by doctor prescription as well as special import permit. So you really have to have a medical condition in these countries to be able to utilize our products. But nonetheless, here in the U.S., it's available over the counter. People can order our product online and have it shipped right to your doorstep to potentially experience the wonderful health and wellness benefits. So here with Canaway, what we had thought is that, you know, yeah, some people are going to use our product because they have some conditions that haven't been successfully treated with the medical community and their approach, and perhaps we have a potential answer for some of these people. But nonetheless, the average person, just like they take vitamin C to improve their overall health and wellness, and of course, if you're sick with a cold or a flu, what do? You take a little extra vitamin C. Same thing, a very similar path with our product. It took vitamin C about 50 years from when it was discovered to the point where it actually became accepted by the medical community. We think we're on a little bit faster track with this. We actually have two divisions that are in pharmaceutical development for cannabis-based, cannabinoid-based actual pharmaceutical medications. And certainly with the focus on research, I think this is what's really going to separate us apart. Anyway, Mike has been the wonderful founder, my business partner for many years. Unfortunately,